So Clash Royale isn't admittedly in its best spot at the current moment. While it's also not at an all-time low by any means, the game has begun to become more and more stale for all players. Newer Clashers are finding a lack of things to do, and endgame players find that gameplay begins to become more and more repetitive. So, of course, we're also due for a major update soon. Because frankly, we haven't had a major update since like July or August of last year with the introduction of Seasons. So, again, I think we're due for an update at this point. So, going into 2020, I want to see the dev team begin to introduce some bigger and better features into the game. So, today, I'm going to be going over 3 major changes that I would like to see come to the game that I believe will give a breath of fresh air and make gameplay a lot more enjoyable overall. Now, these are all going to be major changes to the game. I'm talking about way bigger than simple quality of life changes, because frankly, a list of quality of life changes could be a completely other video in and of itself. So anyways, let's just not waste any extra time, and let's get right into the list. Number 1. Clan Wars. Now I know Clash Royale is already working on a rework for Clan Wars currently, but hey, it's not in the game yet, so I can still say what I want to see come to Clan Wars. Now, when I think Clan Wars, I like to think of Clash of Clans. Now, I know they're 2 different games, but why does Clan Wars work so much better in Clash of Clans than it does in Clash Royale currently? Now, for the most part, I'm also going to be talking about Clan War Leagues as well for those of you who play Clash of Clans, but that's besides the point. Anyways, personally, I think that there are 2 major reasons why Clan Wars is so much better in Clash of Clans. The first is rewards. Of course, we all want to progress in the game, and I think Clash of Clans does an excellent job at pushing a good amount of rewards out to players, especially for just participation. For players in Clash Royale, well, we get a couple more gold for every 2 days if we complete all 3 game modes, and that's literally it, unlike in Clash of Clans, where you get generous rewards after every attack you do. These wars also allow players to earn a currency that you cannot get anywhere else in the game. League medals. These medals are things that you can only earn through participating in war, and opens up an entirely new sector of the game where you're able to purchase simple resources, boosts, magic items, and even customizable features that you can add to your base. This is a perfect system that you could straight up plop into Clash Royale. After winning each collection day battles, give players a free chest or something that they can redeem after winning each match. Then, at the end of the war, maybe in the war sacks, in addition to giving out the existing rewards, introduce something such as the League Medals, which you can redeem in a shop for anything from chests, cards, gold, emotes, maybe even a tower skin for those people who like to save up those points. This would open up an entirely new area of the game only accessible through war. Finally, at the end of these wars, Clash of Clans has something called bonus rewards, where clan leaders can reward players who have participated the most in a war, thus encouraging even more players to play in war. All in all, changes like these that kind of encourage players to participate in war through those incentivized rewards are ways to increase clan cooperation and also make participating in wars a lot more worth a player's time. Now, aside from that, there's also the whole community aspect and gameplay aspect of Clan Wars, and to be honest, this is the hard part, and definitely should be a whole nother video in itself. Let me know your guys' best ideas to improve Clan Wars down below. Number 2. Tournaments. Now, tournaments recently have undergone a pretty positive change. You know, there's now gonna be 1 global tournament per month where the rewards are going to be much greater, and the top 100 players get that exclusive beautiful top emote. So in my opinion, global tournaments are a pretty flushed out feature. I mean, they even do fair play checks so that they can make sure the top 100 players are following the rules and aren't cheating to get to the top. However, today we're not talking about global tournaments. I'm talking about an entire feature of the game nested in this little 3 button thingy up here underneath the training camp button, and that is in-game custom tournament. Now, I'm sure a lot of you guys have completely forgotten about this feature, and I'm not surprised, but there are a few reasons why I think revamping these tournaments could be one of the best things for the Clash Royale community. First off, you have to recognize that tournaments can get you very stacked. Back when tournaments had rewards, it was actually a cheaper way to max out your account compared to actually buying the cards and chests as a whole, so we need a way for players to participate in these tournaments while also managing the Clash Royale economy so that players just kind of aren't cheating the system. I mean, these tournaments already have every single game mode available at all times, so there definitely is a reason for players to play in these modes. They just need that little bit of motivation. So, one way this can be done is by simply adding some rewards. Now beforehand, this was obviously the system in place, and the more gems that you put into creating a tournament, the higher the rewards, which led to people farming those tournaments. However, what if there weren't multiple tiers of rewards? What if there was just one kind of set tournament rewards? You can make a custom tournament for about 50 gems, and if you just have one set of chests that people can collect for finishing top 10, top 50, top 100, so on, then these rewards can be enough to motivate players to play in these tournaments, but not large enough so that people can gem their accounts completely by using tournaments. Now, the reason I think this is the biggest thing Clash Royale can do to improve the Clash Royale community is because back when tournaments were exciting, back when they had rewards, was when the Clash Royale community was the most engaged. There were streamers streaming tournaments all the time. Pro players would often make their top appearances, and lots of streamers nowadays actually had their start streaming these tournaments, forming a community of clashers as well. A good tournament system will do just that for the Clash community once again, giving the Clash Royale player base a reason to join in with content creators and streamers. Number 3, single player mode. Now, Clash Royale has expanded in a lot of different areas in this game. However, the one sector that this game has not touched whatsoever is a single player mode. Clash of Clans has a single player mode, and we already know that there are AI bots in Clash Royale on ladder as well as in training camp, so single player in Clash Royale could offer so much for Clash Royale. First, it could help Clash Royale players improve and hone in on their skill. Taking another look at a feature from Clash of Clans, they have a practice mode where they literally walk you through the basic strategy of different attacks for all different levels of expertise. I think this could be literally perfect in a game of Clash Royale, where there are so many intricate details that you may never figure out unless you see it happen for yourself. In addition, these practice modes have some hefty rewards as well, so like you actually want to complete these tutorials as well. Secondly, a single player map campaign would be another massive expansion for Clash Royale. Again, Clash of Clans has a single player map with like 75 bases or so that you can attack, each increasing in difficulty. In Clash Royale, this could be a set amount of stages with increasing difficulty, which opens up a ton of new game modes that are single player. Game modes such as puzzles, where you have to defend a push with a limited amount of elixir, tower defense modes, where waves of troops heads towards your tower, or even custom maps where you battle against a more polished AI could all be wonderful ways to add more gameplay aspects. And of course, this could be intertwined effectively into a storyline as well. I mean, after all, each arena has its own theme and cards, and if they were connected in just the right way into a series of fun and new game modes and challenges, this could be the perfect way to breathe a big breath of fresh air and strategy into the game, while also improving the skill level of the player base as a whole. So there we go, three of the biggest ideas I think Clash Royale needs to develop heading further into 2020. Of course, they're all massive undertakings, and I believe that Clan Wars should be the first one that they hit. Speaking of new updates coming to the game, of course, the March update is coming closer and closer as we head into the second half of February. In fact, Seth even tweeted on his official Twitter account that they have already filmed their TV Royale for the next season. And considering that it's actually Clash Royale's 4th anniversary in March, I mean, come on, they gotta give us something, right? So look out for a Clash Worlds episode this weekend where I will go over everything that we know so far about season 9. Anyways, all in all, if they at least cover some of the aspects in each of these sections, I think that Clash Royale is going to be in a much better place than it is currently. Now, I'm going to turn the conversation to you guys. What do you guys want to see come to Clash Royale in 2020? Let me know down in the comment section below. But unfortunately, guys, that's all I've got time for in today's episode. If you enjoyed, please leave a like down below as well as a subscription to my channel. And as always, this is London DeRay, and I'm signing off. See you guys next time.